Or I could just keep going and then backtrack once I know where the actual merchant is. Oh wow. Okay, stuff hurts here. I think there might be a boss here. Down there because it's gonna hit me. Maybe I just do this. Even with my flame whip, these guys take two swings to kill. So, gotta continue to be careful. Okay, so here's the steak guy. Now I just gotta find the body part chamber. Then we can move on. This has gotta be a one-way. Back up here, so this is a one-way route either way. Don't want to get knocked backwards. Want to go to the right. I don't know if there's anything in that middle section, but I'm just gonna move on. Can always come back. Oh, boss time. If you can even call it that. This is the Mask of Carmilla, who's one of the reoccurring villains in Castlevania. Her incarnation here is kinda lame. Basically, she just cries bloody tears, heh. And then circles around, and that's it. Not very exciting, especially compared to a lot of the intricate boss designs from other Castlevania games. I don't really want to waste any of my heart items on her, because you know, it's literally just this. Exciting. Okay. You now possess the magic cross, so that's one of the items that I need to complete the game. And here we go. Which body part is this? You now possess Dracula's- oh, the ring. Okay, that's one of the last things I need. One of the last body parts, but good to have. I think we will keep holy water. So now I gotta circle all the way around and get back to the merchant so I can... Oh, hey, she's back. But she doesn't give me anything, so we're gonna move on. I wonder if I can get back up there from here. Going through the middle. To buy another steak before I move on to the next mansion. Oh, no, it just circles around here. Okay, so from here we just go up and around. Ooh, that was close. That Aw, oh, come on. That left path takes me back to the first screen, I believe. Alright, so that's pretty easy to get to. So now we got an oak stake for the next mansion. So this is, like I said, this should be Laruba. So if I head back, I'm trying to think of progression-wise where I am. I'm sort of doing this stuff out of order, I think. This is one of the last mansions you do. That's okay. I'm still on my first life. Whoop. But it's going to be a problem having to figure out the marshes next. Okay, two lives. So, get back to the... I wonder if there's any secrets here. To say that the eye reveals secrets, right? I don't have the eye yet, but we can see if there's any hint books over here. Nope. Oh, wasn't there one in one of these lower sections somewhere? I don't remember. Well, we can move on. To the left was the dead end. Now we gotta get through another marsh. This one was the short one. No, this one was about as long as the other one. If I die in here, is it going to put me in the middle, or is it going to put me back at the end? Well, that's nice. At least they don't stick you all the way back on the far end. That would just be annoying. Okay. So from here, we're going to head all the way to the right, to where the 10 enemies are, and move through there. I guess we could see if there's anything up at the top. I don't think there's anything up here. No, it doesn't look like it. Keep moving. Got the flame whip, which is the most important thing to get here. Yeah, there's nothing up there. Ooh, it's kind of a leap of faith. Couldn't remember if the platforms went all the way across that section. I think we're done in this section of the map. Okay, we gotta do this mansion. This should be boldly... Which... I believe the last mansion is technically more difficult. So find out. cut off from the top route. So if I find the steak guy, then I know where to backtrack to once I get the body part here. I think maybe the eyes in this section.